The Arch Linux Wiki recommends installing the LTS kernel if you want more stability. But what is the kernel? What is the difference between the default and the LTS kernels? Which one should you use? In this video, you will find out. Hello everyone, it's Arch Linux User, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. I make video tutorials every Wednesday and Friday. Subscribe and hit that bell notification, so you won't miss any new video. You probably have heard that in Arch Linux you can install the LTS kernel. It is often recommended installing if you want to make your Arch system more stable. I also listed the LTS kernel as one of my recommendations in the video 10 things to do first in Arch Linux. But I didn't explain why I recommended the LTS kernel. I will do it in this video. The kernel is the core program of your system. The kernel is responsible for managing memory, CPU, and the other hardware of your system. Many drivers are built in the kernel. It also communicates with the installed applications. Actually, Linux is the kernel. The desktop, applications, and all the other stuff is just a superstructure above the kernel. So using the word Linux is not very accurate, if you mean a distribution. For example, Android uses Linux kernel, but it is not called Linux. That is why many people say GNU Linux when they mean Linux distributions. But I prefer to use just Linux, because it is simpler. So it's obvious the kernel is a very important part. It is a key part of your operating system. If you have not changed your kernel in Arch Linux, by default you have the latest stable kernel. It is 4.12.4 at the time of recording this video, while the LTS kernel version is 4.9.41. As you can see, the stable version is a little outdated. The LTS version is advantageous if stability is your first priority. It doesn't mean that the latest kernel, in other words the default kernel, is less stable. It just means that LTS kernel won't be updated as frequently. So there is a smaller chance of some conflicts after you update your system. Besides, the LTS kernel doesn't change much. So if it works fine on your system, it is likely will keep working fine. On the other hand, the latest kernel is updated frequently, and there are constant changes to it. So there is a higher chance of breaking something after the update. The main version of the LTS kernel doesn't change, but it keeps receiving security fixes and it may also receive some feature backports. The latest kernel is good if you want to have the latest features. And this is what many Arch Linux users aim for. If you have the latest hardware, it is possible that the LTS kernel may not fully support it. So you have to use the latest kernel. I personally use the LTS kernel, and I am very happy with it. So it is up to you what kernel to use. I recommend trying the LTS kernel. If everything works fine, stick to it. If not, use the latest kernel. Installing and activating the LTS kernel in Arch Linux is easy. You just need to do these few steps. First, check your current kernel version. It is not LTS, as you can see. Install the LTS kernel. Update your bootloader. If you use grub, run this command. Reboot your system. After the reboot, you should see this menu. If you don't see it, press Shift or Escape key during the boot time to enter this grub menu. Then go to the Advanced options and select to boot with the LTS kernel. After you logged into your system, check the kernel version and make sure it is LTS version. Now you can remove the latest kernel and keep only the LTS kernel. If you use the latest kernel, you can install the LTS kernel as a fallback kernel. If something happens to your latest kernel, you can boot with the LTS kernel. In my previous Arch Linux videos, I received many comments that did not recommend the LTS kernel. The arguments were sort of, I use Arch Linux to have the latest and the greatest features. Why would I use not the latest kernel version? I think this point of view has its right to exist. But the LTS kernel is not that old. The LTS kernel has several benefits personally for me. I had some problems with the latest kernel and the VirtualBox, because the kernel updates were more frequent than the updates for VirtualBox. Once VirtualBox just stopped working, and to fix it, I needed to switch to an older kernel. I also like the infrequent updates of the LTS kernel. I multi-boot my Arch Linux with several other Linux OSs. and I need to update my group manually every kernel update. I explained this procedure in my video, dual boot Arch Linux with another Linux. I don't have to update my group often with the LTS kernel. So I prefer the LTS kernel. What is your choice? Please comment below. Thank you for watching.